Today we chat with Ivo Georgiev, the co-founder and chairman of Paynetics, a fintech company that focuses on payments solutions. He talks about the goals, trends, and obstacles facing the future of digital payments.
Hi, my name is Aya Karleva, and thank you for joining us for an interview for Financial IT.
I'm Ivo Georgiev, founder and chairman of Paynetics. I co-founded the company 6 years ago, and we are what I call the next generation of payment institution, what I call the regulated fintech. We're trying to basically simplify payments and democratize payments. That's kind of our mission in life.
What are your goals for Paynetics, big and small?
The big goal is to come up with solutions that actually make life simpler. Another big goal of ours is to change the way merchants take payments. I mean, if you look at the world at the moment, there are about 140 million merchants, traders who do not accept anything but cash. And the big trend now being everywhere, everybody's moving to cashless society. We turn any Android phone, any Android device into a payment acceptance. So merchants do not need to go and buy a hardware. They can just use their phone to take payments from a card, take payments from another wallet. And our third goal is to help everyone become a fintech. I mean, the way we see the future is that every company can be a fintech. And with our digital banking platform that we have created, we have the unique ability to provide a combination between software as a service and payment as a service. So any company that has client base and they're interested in providing financial services, and we can actually empower them. This is what I call the fintech in a box, because we provide the technology, we provide the regulatory framework, we provide the ongoing support in running a digital banking business.
Recently, Google added another 6 banks to the Google Pay digital account services that is launching in 2021. Moreover, Apple and Google have removed the Fortnite video game from their respective app stores. What do these two major developments indicate for digital banking and payment spaces?
Big tech commands enormous power. I mean, they have billions of users. I mean, if you look at their balance sheets, they have pretty much unlimited financial resources. But the most important thing is that they control very large parts of the infrastructure. So whether it's mobile or search or internet or social media, email even. This sector provides an obvious area of growth for people like Apple or Facebook or Google. Second of all, the question is, how will these guys use this power that they have? Of course, if left undisturbed by the regulators. So I think they have two fundamental choices. I mean, either they continue to develop the platform they are and be the platform, or they start to evolve from controlling the rails to running their own trains on these rails. But if you look at Google, they have a different approach so far. I think they want to be the platform. They don't necessarily want to run their own content or run their own rails. Yes, they launched their card. They launched the accounts in cooperation with our banks, which is a first step. I think they're testing the water to see how it's going to happen. It's also possible at some point of time they're going to internalize this whole process within Google and launch their own products. Thirdly, the exclusion of Fortnite from both stores shows the extreme power these people command and their commitment to safeguard the position they have. The implications for payments and digital banking could be very significant. I mean, all of us at the moment rely on the Apple Store and the Google Play Store. But imagine a situation where a bank, for example, that has kind of millions of users, all of a sudden is excluded from this platform for whatever reasons. I mean, obviously, this will cause a lot of disturbances. And I have to ask myself today, and I guess everybody's asking themselves, what can we do to basically mitigate this risk? So maybe there will be kind of alternative channel being developed just to safeguard these large institutions from being held hostages in a way.
Will the future of payments be driven by a new breed of regulated fintechs? And what are your predictions on that?
The company is also to understand extremely well the intricacy of payments, because it's fairly, I mean, apart from being very regulated business, it's fairly complicated business at the moment. And it's not that easy to match this intricacy of payments and complexity of payments with the digital requirement of the consumer. I see several trends here. One is that there'll be new companies coming up with the large banks that would have to adapt themselves, either by bringing talent or by buying fintechs or even by buying services. Well, I mean, I give you an example. We, with our digital banking platform, we empower banks as well. And the funny thing is that we provide the actual banking product to the clients of the banks. When you think about it, it doesn't make a lot of sense because the bank is there to provide banking services. But because they don't necessarily have the technological ability to provide these new products and new services that require, for example, tokenization or digitalization of the cards, they actually outsource what is kind of their core business to people like us. On the other side, we'll have fintechs that will evolve to become financial institutions. I mean, the perfect example is Revolut. But the end result is this new regulated fintech, which answers the need of the consumer and at the same time has one way or the other this deep understanding and domain knowledge of payments.
Thank you for talking to us about Paynetics and the future of fintech, and all the best.
Thank you. Thank you for having me.